Hello, my name is Anthony Hall, and in this tutorial we're going to look at three basic tools. We're going to look at the bevel tool, the chamfer tool, and the rounder tool. So let's start off with the bevel tool. So I've got three boxes here, they're all on the same layer, so I'm going to make sure I'm on polygons, and then what I'm going to do is I'm just going to select just one polygon and then click the bevel and N on the keyboard to put numerical up. So first one, without just clicking normal, you can bring it up and in or out. There is an outer and an inner option. When you're bringing it up like this, if you want to make a double bevel, so another bevel on top of it, you right mouse click and then it will add another bevel, and right mouse click again and it will add another bevel. If you want it to only bevel one way, so what I mean, if you want it to bevel in and not up, if you hold control on your keyboard, click and bevel, it will lock it to one way only, so you can't bring it up if you try and go up, look, it just goes sideways. So again, when you do the new bevel, if you hold control and click, it will only go up this time, because that's the first way I went. If I hold control and click sideways, it will only come in. And then again, hold control and up to go up, so you get different types of bevel. So let me just stop that, undo all the little moves I've just made, go back to bevel again, bring up the numerical. When you also do a new bevel, if you wish, you can assign it to a new surface, so you'll get a new surface for the whole of the bevel here if you want, and you can give it a new name and so on. And like I said before, you can do an outer bevel, which again does it the opposite way round, so it's actually going outwards, a bit like the top of a bit of a house or a roof, that way, like so. To be honest, it's not something I use a lot of, the outer bevel, but again, you can control all this with your actual numerical, so if you know exactly the bevel you want to do, you can do that and go along with it. Okay, so other things you can do is, obviously you can try and use a bevel tool on two sides like this, so it will do it on the other sides as well as this top and the bottom if you wish. You can only use the bevel tool, so if I go onto edges and choose edges, it goes dull, so you can't use it on that. And then on points, if I select points, again, it don't work. So it's only a polygon based tool. So again, if I just go to discs, what we could do is, with the polygon selected, if I wanted to make maybe a wheel, I could select the top, hold shift, the bottom, bevel. So I'm gonna bevel it in, so I'm holding control and I'm just clicking inwards, like so. And then I'm going to bevel it with the right mouse a couple of times, making all these different edges. I can then, if I wanted to, right mouse click and hold control and bring it inwards, like so. So I've got this kind of wheel, drop the selection. Then if I press tab on the keyboard, that will kind of smooth it round, like so. If you get this kind of edge inside, what you need to do is select them both, like so, and then go under the multiply tab, go to more and make a pole, so it gives you the inside bit there, so you've got a kind of type of wheel there. And then obviously if you want, you can come use the actual modify the stretch, and you can stretch it in. Remember, I've got all of them on at the same time, so you might want to with the polygon tool, right mouse click and select all the polygons, so you're not selecting the other objects inside it, and then you can stretch it. When I'm using stretch, I'm going to hold control and just stretch it in, so I can decide again what kind of depth my wheel is if I want, and then I can texture the inside there if I want as some kind of island way, and the rest as a tire and so on. So we can use it in that way if you want to. I mean, the other option is I could bevel it in a few times if I want to do this wheel. So I'm going to bevel it, right bevel it till how, let's say to about there, and then under construct is it bridge, and what bridge will do is it'll bridge the gap between, giving you a gap, and then if you press the tab key you'll get this shape as well. Okay, so very basic bevel tool, be nice if it could be updated. So again, let's go on back onto cube, and now let's have a look at the chamfer tool. So with the chamfer, very similar, bring the numerical up, it bevels like so, and obviously if you right mouse click on this one it doesn't really actually do anything. If you hold control down it doesn't do anything, hold shift and again doesn't necessarily do anything, it just chamfers, in a way bevels the edge. But this is different in a way that if I undo this, if I was to jump to my edges and I only wanted, let's say, this edge, and I'm holding shift while I do this, this edge, I've selected that edge as well, and I wanted all those chamfering, I can chamfer all the way around just those edges like that, which is quite cool. Okay, on top of that, what I could do as well is if I go to points down here, let's select the four points in the corner here like so, and now let's chamfer them. So, and then you can chamfer these as well, look, like so, so you get the nice edges. So that's another way you can chamfer, which is quite cool. If I go to the balls, I've got some balls here, let's use the edge and let's choose a line for it to follow, let's say down here, across and across, let's say there, and then let's chamfer it out like so, about there, press space bar, say I've done, and you get this nice edge now. So what I could do is I could jump to my polygon tool and select this row of polys that I've just made with the chamfer tool, not that bottom one, and then let's use a smooth shift to pull it out slightly. Where you can pull it out, you can pull it in, so I can go like that, drop space bar and tool, so then again you can do that kind of thing with it, which is quite nice. With the discs, I could chamfer top of the discs like so. If I undo that, let's do the other side and let's again chamfer that in, it's quite nice. Forward slash, I've got the selection, so I've got this nice, go back to, let's just say this top, I could use a bevel tool, hold control to bring it in, and then I could use a smooth shift which will then suck it in, bevel tool, bring it in, and so on. So you get the gist of it. So you come in that with this, and obviously if you tab it you've got this shape as well to go on with. So yeah, the chamfer tool is basically beveling, basic beveling, but you can do it on polygons, edges and points. And so let's go to the last one, let's just keep coming back to undo this a bit, and let's try the rounder tool. So with the rounder tool, we're going to click it, bring the numerical up like so, and then you just start deciding, sorry, just bring the new, press N on the keyboard, and based on what you've got here is how high the insert distance is and how many polygons you want around those edges. So that's on the basic one. So I'm just going to go as simple as that. I only really use these ones. I mean, you click the points, and what this will do is it'll do the side bits, like so, a bit like the chamfer tool, but I don't use it that much. So let's say I was happy with that. Okay, let's see what happens if I go to edges, and let's say I just wanted these two to have some kind of rounded edges. So let's click rounder, numerical, and again you've got that kind of rounded edge just on that one side, which is quite cool. And then on this side, let's have a look, see what happens if I choose these two points, click the rounder and numerical, and then what it does, it rounds just that edge that we're using there And again, you can bring it down as far as you want and add a few more bits to it, like so. If we just go on to here, let's see what it does on the rounder on here. So rounder, numerical. Now, based on my last settings, it's kind of literally made this into a dome. So let's bring it up a bit, like so. Reduce this, see if it'll let me reduce the size. Yeah, 6, like so. Which is not bad. So again, you can't really do a lot with the rounder tool in a situation like this, because it's already rounded, and obviously Lightwave's like, what is it you want me to do with this? So let's just bring it very low and bring it up, see what we can do. So that's 1 mil. So you can see in there it's trying to do it, but the problem is it's got no hard edge to work on. So you can use it to maybe add this row of polys, but again, I can't say I've ever used it on anything like this. I mean, we can try selecting these polys here. Let's smooth shift it up in the air. Let's just unsub patch it, go back to making that into one poly. So let's go to detail, merge the polys, and why it's selected, see if it'll do it. Numerical, so you can see it's trying to do it. It's got too many sides, bring it down. So again, it needs that hard edge to round. But again, three completely different basic tools that you can use in different ways and work together to kind of create whatever it is you want to create, basically. So I mean, like most things and like most tools, it's a matter of experimenting and seeing how far you can push the tool to its limit before it'll let you stop working, and so on. So yeah, so that's a very quick basic bevel, chamfer and rounder without going into too much detail and just introducing you to it. So yeah, have a play, see how you get on with. Thanks for listening.